Welcome back to my channel. Our topic today is how to train a Yorkie not to bark. What triggers a Yorkie's bark? Protection. Barking out of protection is an ordinary reaction toward what considered a threat to a Yorkie. If someone steps on his territory, they'll receive a series of vocalization from him. Fear. Fear is definitely among the most common causes of barking. Sometimes, your Yorkie is scared of some certain things and vocalize to both defend himself and threaten back to what seems to be a danger. Anxiety. Anxiety-based barks usually occur when your Yorkie is left alone, also called separation anxiety. He's anxious when you're not around. With such a feeling, he'll start barking the second you walk out of the door or even leave the room where he's in. Boredom. Being left alone also brings your Yorkie a sense of boredom. Barking is to break the silence and get the atmosphere more bustling. Dogs cannot stand loneliness for so long without anything for entertaining. Your attention. If you find him looking at you attentively and barking, it's your attention he's trying to catch. By barking, he may tell you to bring him out or feed him. And he knows such a noise will earn a look from you, so he just enjoys doing it. Playing and greeting. Ridiculous as it may sound, barking is how dogs communicate. Communication with humans doesn't come easily to a dog due to an obvious conflict in language. While playing, excitement can also cause a bit of bark. You'll often hear it while your Yorkie is waving his tail and jumping round. Different tones of noises. Low tone barking. This kind of barking is a warning about a perceived threat, or what they feel like a suspicious change in the environment. Your Yorkie is incredibly sensitive to a sudden change, whether of place or unfamiliar and startling sounds. High-pitched barking. Barking in a higher tone is a sign of seeking attention. The chances are he's in need of your help or something like outdoor activities or relieving himself. Growling. You'll often hear growling followed by a low-tone bark, which indicates a warning for danger. As I said, a threat could be anything outside the street or in your own house. Don't be surprised if an appearance of a cockroach can trigger a bark from your Yorkie. Howling. Howling often takes place when your Yorkie hears other dogs calling. It's communication. Whining. Whining comes with emotional distress. If he realizes your absence or if he's in the confinement area with the desire to get out, he might whine. Another special case of whining is when your Yorkie is in pain or doesn't want to be touched. The sound is to tell you how much pain he has to suffer and ask for your help to ease this uncomfortable feeling. Yelping. Yelping is also a high-pitched sound, but much quicker and higher than attention-seeking bark. The yelp will come out once your Yorkie is injured painfully. When you hear it, immediately check on him to find out what happened, if he's okay or not. How to train a Yorkie not to bark. 1. Removing distractions. As aforementioned, a Yorkie is sensitive to changes in the environment when a startling noise indoor or any external sound can trigger his bark. So first, remove all those distractions. Block the sounds from outside by turning on a white noise machine or playing a soothing kind of music. It's a way to calm his mind down and be relaxed. You have to make your home an absolutely safe place for him to stay. Try your best to do your own activities in the slightest noise you can. 2. Socializing. Barking also comes as a way to greet others, but after all, it's not the only way. That's why you need to socialize your dog, specifically your Yorkie, so that he can know more comfortable and soundless ways to say hello. Take him for a frequent walk. Fresh air and physical activities will help alleviate his stress and anxiety. Also, when he's worn out, there's no strength left for barking. 3. Desensitization. This is a special technique used to familiarize your Yorkie with what seems to be the danger, like a doorbell, for example. Step 1. At a random time of a day, have someone ring the doorbell until you open the door. When barking starts to go off, command him to sit. Step 2. In a calm tone, show a sign to your Yorkie that everything is okay, the doorbell is not a danger. Show him that you're not afraid of it by a calm expression. Step 3. When he sees no reason for barking, he'll stop. And each time he does, within 3 seconds of pausing, immediately give him verbal praise and a small treat. Treats work perfectly on motivating him to do the decent behavior next time. Step 4. Each time your Yorkie starts to bark, if you glance to notice no health-related issue, completely ignore him. Continue to do your own work. Hopefully, because he realizes barking doesn't bring your attention, which in turn means no treats, no praise, and no fun, he'll finally stop. It sticks to his mind that barking is nothing but a waste of time. Step 5. After associating the treats and the silence, barking behavior will have the tendency to diminish. But don't stop practicing. Practice makes perfect. 4. Being calm. Being calm is the key to this training. As you get angry, nothing will be properly solved. It's easy for your dog to pick up on your energy, so don't be grumpy in the face. No matter how annoying it might sound, calm yourself down and use a firm and gentle voice tone to correct his behavior. 5. Bark collars. Bark collars are particularly useful for owners who are usually away from home and at bedtime. However, if you decide to use the bark collar, choose an appropriate, high-quality one. Ones that use sound or vibration are more advisable because they cause no pain to your Yorkie. A painful shock leads to further aggression, so be wise when purchasing one for your teacup. That's all I want to share about how to train a Yorkie not to bark. Interested in finding out more information about dogs, puppies, and ways to train them well, please subscribe and follow us. Thank you all.